Hello guitaristas, my name is Adina and you are watching the Spanish Guitar Hub, and today we are going to learn the top 5 flamenco chords. Using these chords you can reach a better Spanishy or flamenco sound, so let's see what are these chords to improve your sound. By the way guys, I have a guitar course which is called Spanish Guitar Strumming Techniques. It has 19 guitar lessons and loads of exercises. So if you would like to learn the right hand strumming as well and using those chords that we are learning today, please sign up for my guitar course on the link under below or going to Amazon and ordering the book there. Number 5 is flat 9. So this was E major flat 9, or you can also do it on the A major. Just adding this extra note, then you can have this kind of dark flamenco sound. So how you hold it? You just hold an E major chord and then you add your little finger on the 3rd fret of the D string. So basically just adding an F note to our E major chord. Or if you hold it in the A major version, then you need to hold the flamenco A major, which means you are holding 2 strings down with your index finger and 1 string down with your middle finger. And you add the 3rd fret on the G string. So let's see some examples how this can sound. The dominant 7. Probably this sound is quite familiar to you because it occurs in a lot of different music, but adding dominant 7 will make you sound so much more Spanishy and so much better. Especially if you add the B7, it occurs in so many flamenco songs, in so many rumba songs, it is all over in the Gypsy King songs as well. So adding this kind of chord will make it sound so much better. So let's see how this can sound in some of the examples. The diminished chord. The diminished has again a quite dark sound and it is just holding the 2-3-2-3. Let's see how does that sound if we add it in a context. For example, we can play Bulleria and adding the diminished chord. See, in this kind of chord progression, there was also a flat 7 and it was B flat 7, but it was like an open B flat 7, so instead of holding a barre, I just hold it on the open. That's again another typical thing when you play flamenco music, that there are this kind of lot of open chords available and then it makes it sound quite special. So far we were just doing this kind of dark sound, so let's see how does it will sound if we add something a little bit more brighter and more beautiful. So in some of the flamenco songs you can hear like 9th chords or minor 9th chords. So for example, the E minor 9th sounds like this. Or you can also add major 7th, which is a very beautiful chord again. Okay, so let's see how these two chords together would sound like if we add it in a context. This was a combination in between E minor 9th and also C major 7th. And of course I need to mention the major and minor chords, because in flamenco and Spanish guitar there is full of major and minor chords, but what it makes it sound flamenco or Spanish is what you use in your right hand, what kind of technique do you use in your right hand, also what kind of chord progression you are using. Obviously a lot of you are know this very typical Spanish chord progression, which is only major and minor chords. So, A minor, G major, F major, E major. Or also you can do like a farruca, which is E major, A minor, D minor, A minor. Actually added a dominant 7 because it just sounds a little bit better with dominant 7. If you would like to have the tabs for all of these exercises that I did during this lesson, then please go to my Patreon campaign, because it is available on my Patreon campaign. And hopefully see you guys next week, because I'm coming back every Sunday with a new guitar video. So see you guys next week with another guitar video. Hello guitaristas, my name is Adina and you are watching the Spanish Guitar Hub, and today we are going to learn the rasgueado technique, and after this lesson you can play something like this. By the way guys, I have a guitar course which is called Spanish Guitar Strumming Techniques.